That I just keep feeling that despite the fact that we're all saying these amazing things about Bob, there's no way we can begin to say or approach or in any way encompass or describe to each other anything about what an incredible person he was. And he made a deep impression on everybody who ever met him. I mean, unforgettable.
A week or so ago, I wasn't around. I didn't see him, but I got this message through Kirsten and through the phone that he went to see Bobby, didn't know that he had died. And he left this poem and asked me if I would read it here. So I haven't really read it yet, so I'm just going to read it. And this man, he didn't even leave his phone number. I can't even call him, but here's his poem. It's called The Draftsman. Lines that intersect form a relationship that goes beyond the page forever. No matter how far the ends travel, the crosses in life mark where we have been. Sometimes the X's gather things about them. An island forms. Some grass grows, perhaps a flower, occasionally a tree, a place to stroll about and wonder at the intricate quality of these connections. So we gather and our love builds and reminds us of its own beauty. And Jim Finney. As for myself, I don't think I can really talk about Bob today, but I can say facts. I met Bob when I was about 11, and we've had, similar to everybody, probably very adversarial relationship most of that time, and yet in the last maybe 10 years, I've been as close to him as I've been to anybody. And my kids too are close. We're close to him, and I miss him very much. I miss his view of the world. I miss the window that he provided.
And didn't Bob paint a lot of these beautiful aquarelle paintings for Sienna?
Yeah, Sienna and Bob did a lot of oil painting together the last year of his life, even the last week of his life, I think. Mm. They also did a lot of cooking together, which was very odd. Sienna thought he was a great chef. And she would call him on the phone to go up and make food with him. And I'm sorry that Sienna's not here, because Bob was very important to her. So.
But Samir's here, and he played the drum. That's great.
En este lugar tan sagrado.
And something that I really admire about this place that is so sacred
es el cómo honran a los ancestros, cómo recuerdan a los que nos antecedieron.
Is how the ancestors, those who came before us, are honored and are remembered.
Por lo que me decía ahora Patty y también Stephanie.
And from what Patty and Stephanie were telling me earlier,
siento que este hombre en realidad fue como un apuntalar desde lo muy, desde lo más profundo de su corazón, ¿verdad? Hacia la historia de hacia la historia de nosotros aquí, de, del Brown Cope. Sí, un arranque.
I feel like this man was really sort of a connection between his own heart and this place and the history of Bread and Puppet.
Nos hace recordar, y para los jóvenes que están aquí, que hay muchos jóvenes, ¿verdad?, en el Bread and Puppet, se recordar de dónde venimos, desde dónde empezamos, desde dónde iniciamos la lucha, ¿no?
And it makes us remember, especially for the young people that are here at Bread and Puppet, where this comes from, where this struggle originated.
Recordar desde dónde tensamos el arco y desde dónde apuntamos la flecha, ¿no?
And to remember from where the bow was began and where the arrow was pointed.
Recordar también los fundamentos con los que construimos todo este resurgimiento de vitalidad, de espiritualidad, de fortaleza.
And to remember the foundation upon which all of this spirituality and vitality and life is built.
Porque este gran hombre apuntó y dio en el blanco que él se propuso.
Because this great man set his sight on a target and hit that target that what he had set out to hit.
Nos marcó un poco el camino, nos llevó el ritmo, nos ha llevado el ritmo y sigue llevándonos el ritmo y sigue marcando los pasos.
And he laid out the way, he laid out a path, and he continues to mark that path, to give rhythm to that path, to our steps.
Un hombre que no perdió el norte, pero tampoco perdió el sur.
A man who didn't lose which way is north, but also didn't lose which way is south.
Siento que profundamente que está presente realmente aquí, ¿no? Sigue presente entre nosotros, ¿no?
And I feel deeply that he is here and he's still present among us.
Es la lucha que mantuvo él desde que se inició en la lucha. Una lucha por la paz, una lucha por la justicia, una lucha porque el mundo sea mejor, porque el mundo cambie. Honrar su memoria, bueno, es un eterno gracias a esa persona, ¿no?, tan maravillosa. Es decirle gracias eternamente.
And to honor his memory is really a form of eternal thanks to this person.
Y yo lo resumiría en una sola palabra. El testimonio de él en una sola palabra, lo resumiría.
And I would summarize his testimony in one word.
Consecuencia, porque siento que fue un hombre consecuente desde que comenzó su lucha.
Constancy.
Commitment.
Sí.
Escribí una cosa, pero es muy larga. Así que entregaría esto luego a Peter y a sus familiares, ¿no? Pero es maravilloso que realmente que el Bread and Puppet honre de esta forma a sus ancestros, a su a su memoria, ¿no?
And I wrote something, but it's really long, so I'll give it to Peter later. But I think it's really wonderful that Bread and Puppet honors its ancestors in this way.
Quiero aprovechar este momento. No sé si voy a tener otro momento para darle, para decir gracias, expresar mi gratitud, enorme gratitud a todos, a Peter, a Elka, a Linda, a Michael, a todos los que están aquí, porque me hacen tan feliz, ¿verdad?, de poder darme cuenta que realmente el mundo puede mejorar, que realmente el mundo puede conducirse mejor. Gracias.
And I want to take this opportunity also, because I don't know if I'll have another chance, to give my very deep thanks to everybody here at Bread and Puppet, to Peter, Elka, Linda, Michael, to everybody really for showing me that that it is possible, that there is a way to change the world.
I remember, like, when we were young adults and we were trying to find some critical reasons from Bread and Puppet Theater, and we were kind of trying out our own versions of art and theater making, my siblings and friends and stuff like that. Like, Bob might have been into the little kids, but he's also really into, like, the rebellions of, like, the young adults and stuff. But he was always told me, like, so when we're getting into, like, postmodern theory and stuff like that, and being like, ah, Bread and Puppet is, you know, all doing all these reduced, simplistic, blah, blah. Bob was totally into that. He totally encouraged it. I felt like he was, like, this cool grown-up who was an ally for our kind of, like, critical inquiries and kind of attempts at, you know, other forms of, you know, dissent and rebellion and cultural experimentation and stuff like that. And anyways, so he was like a real amazing ally in that. And he always had that radical spirit to the very end. And I'm sure him and the old man had lots of differences and stuff like that. He was a real, walked his own path, I guess.
An holy bliss for which it pants in my Redeemer's breast. And I'll sing hallelujah, and you'll sing hallelujah. And we'll all sing hallelujah when we arrive at home. And I'll sing hallelujah, and you'll sing hallelujah. And we'll all sing hallelujah when we arrive at home. Oh, what are all my sufferings here if, Lord, thou count me meet with that enraptured host up here and worship at thy feet. And I'll sing hallelujah, and you'll sing hallelujah. And we'll all sing hallelujah when we arrive at home. And I'll sing hallelujah, and you'll sing hallelujah. And we'll all sing hallelujah when we arrive at home. Give joy or grief, give ease or pain, take life or friends away. But let me find them all again in that eternal day. And I'll sing hallelujah, and you'll sing hallelujah. And we'll all sing hallelujah when we arrive at home. Body down.